First of all, I appreciate the honor immensely. At this time, really receiving this on behalf of a collaborative group of investigators that I'll come back to a bit. The award itself is going into a fund to support research by postdoctoral and predoctoral trainees, which we're also very appreciative of. I want to say a few words about the paper itself, because it really is reflective of a number of areas that we all feel very passionate about. First, Ryan Gann, who is the first author of this paper, was a graduate student in epidemiology of Jill Norris, who is the chair of epidemiology at the University of Colorado. And Ryan is a very talented person who, in addition to doing this work as a collaborative adventure with the Leiden group, has done a number of other studies in preclinical rheumatoid arthritis in at-risk populations, perhaps most notably showing that individuals who have high titer autoantibodies but don't yet have rheumatoid arthritis have a very profound defect in their levels of omega-3 fatty acids, and we think probably resolvins. And because of that, we're actually looking very carefully at now looking at a preclinical RA prevention study using these epidemiologic findings. So it's really indicative of the science of epidemiology and how that can intersect with our understanding of disease and also then lead to therapeutic trials and awareness. Ryan has actually gone on now and is a postdoc at Colorado State University, which has a tremendous atmospheric, believe it or not, atmospheric sciences group. And what he's looking at is the effect of climate change and atmospheric changes on autoimmune disease and inflammatory disease. And because they have access to some of the best space-based analytic systems, he's really looking at it on a large scale. So Ryan is really one of our star graduates, and really appreciative of that. The other point to make is that this is really indicative of what is also a necessity and an increasingly important approach that we have in a collaborative international adventure. And that is, we've done this study with our collaborators in Leiden, and the Leiden group has identified this very interesting autoantibody system, and subsequent to that, some other ones, and we've continued to not only do this study to understand how this autoantibody system in rheumatoid arthritis leads to or is associated with future disease, but also a number of other ones, and we continue to work with them. So these are two features which I think are important to all of us, graduate students, trainees, maintaining them in our discipline, and also a very strongly collaborative adventure. And I'm really pleased about this award, and thank you very much again on behalf of this group.